Konnichiwa, one and all. This is a tutorial on the product rule. For all my other tutorials, visit mathormaths.com. So before I show you how to do the product rule, you need to understand why we're doing the product rule. The product rule happens when you are differentiating the product, which means one function, multiplied by another function, two separate functions. So let's just look at these three functions here. Why don't you pause the video and see if you can say which one needs the product rule. I'm going to tell you. Okay, let's just analyse them. I'll start with the bottom one first. We have the sine of 3x squared. Now that's just one function. And remember, when you see sine squared, what it's actually saying is the sine of 3x all squared. Now that's not a function times a function, that's a function inside a function. Although, if you wanted to, you could write that as sine 3x times sine 3x and do the product rule. We're not going to do that today. Let's consider the middle function. Well, once again, this is the sine of 3x squared. It's just the one function there. And again, you would probably use the chain rule for that. Which, of course, leaves me with this at the top. We have x squared, completely separately, and that is multiplied by sine 3x. We have two separate functions multiplied together, so we can use the product rule on that. So here we have a function multiplied by a function, the first and the second function. Now, you may see in textbooks these are called u and v. The product rule simply says the first times the derivative of the second plus the second times the derivative of the first. But if you just remember that in your head, you don't really need to use any particular formula. So dy by dx equals the first, that was x squared, times the derivative of the second. Well, the derivative of sine 3x is 3 cosine 3x. And if you're not sure how I did that so quickly, you need to see some other tutorials. Plus the second, which is sine 3x, times the derivative of the first. The derivative of x squared is 2x. Now I'm just going to tidy that up. So that's 3x squared. I've put the number first because that looks prettier. Cosine. And that 3x there is attached to that cosine. You don't need brackets, but you might find it helps you. Plus, I'm going to bring the 2x to the front. And I have sine, and that 3x there is attached to the sine. So you can't factorise or bring those forwards. And that's it. First times the derivative of the second, plus the second times the derivative of the first. So let me just show you one more example. Looks complicated, but it's not. So once again, I have two completely separate functions, the logarithm and the sine function. You might want to call one u and v, but I'm just going to launch straight in with the first times the derivative of the second, plus the second times the derivative of the first. So the first is the natural logarithm of x. I'm just going to keep that in brackets to keep it separate. The derivative of the second. Now this uses the chain rule. The sine of anything goes to the cosine of the same thing. But I need to times by the derivative of that something. The derivative of x squared is 2x. Now if you need help, do watch my tutorial on the chain rule. Plus the second, which is the sine of x squared, times the derivative of the first. The derivative of the natural logarithm of x is 1 over x. Okay, now all I'm going to do is show you how we can tidy that up easily, remembering what goes with what. So I'm going to bring that 2x to the front. 2x times the natural logarithm of x times the cosine of x squared. And if you want to put that in brackets, feel free. Plus. Now, the most common mistake is to try and cancel out that x and that x squared. That x squared is part of that sine. So there's nothing I can do here. I could bring 1 over x to the front, or what I sometimes do, I think it just looks a little bit neater, is just take it underneath. But there's no tidying up more you can do there. So there we go. All you need to remember, first times derivative of the second, plus the second times derivative of the first. For many more tutorials and loads of mathematical advice and help, visit mathormaths.com. And do get in touch via any of the media displayed on the screen. Most of my videos are made to request. And one last request of you, please share this video, not for me, but for your friends. If you help some of your friends do well on the exam, I know they will thank you. So put this on your Facebook timeline or tweet about it. Most of all, revise well, work hard, and good luck in your examinations. You are going to do awesome.